Fuck you! May be seated! I want to thank Mary Lou for the really mediocre organ playing. Now, many of you may have noticed this stressed and sweaty man sitting here next to me. This is the district pastor, Reginald Wallace. No relation to Braveheart. Now, he come up here to encourage me, his fellow pastor. Well, so he says. And to dispel the demons of rumors. Rumors of assumption. Assumption would be a mighty poignant subject for today. Because as you look on your calendar, you will find that today is Assumption Day. Now, Assumption, that's all about Mary and her body being lifted up to heaven. Assumption is not about assuming your pastor is rich simply because he drives a Lexus. Now, Brother David, he owns himself a medium-sized business, no bigger than 10 football fields just crammed with automobiles that could go to the needy, but don't. Now, why is that? Why is it that Brother David lives in a mansion on the top of a hill, playing God, loading it over us all, and yet he can't find it in his heart or in his wallet to tithe 10%? God said it, Brother David, so stop being a Jew. It is assumed, because I am your pastor, that I can work miracles. I cannot pray your herpes away, Ben. A miracle. That's like our sweet baby Jesus. An immaculate conception. An event that happened one time, in spite of the naive beliefs of some of the parents here in our fine community. Sexual intercourse is supposed to occur only between soulmates. And Brother Richard, no matter what you say, a horse is not your soulmate. Now, with all this sinning going on in our little flock right here, why is it that certain sheep will go right behind the shepherd's back and making reports to the pastor's association? Now, do I need to remind you of what they do to snitches in heaven? Same thing as they do to them in prison. As many of you know, I was saved by Jesus in our state correctional facility. I lived a sinful life, full of promiscuous sex, Sister Barbara. Heavy drug use, Brother Jacob. And the occasional drive-by shooting in front of various houses of a minority group that I have learned to call African Americans. But Pastor Planky here, Pastor Planky doesn't need to assume. He can look straight into each one of your little hearts. Every blessed one of you that would report his, quote, unorthodox methods. I like to think of them as old-fashioned. So old-fashioned, they go all the way back to medieval times. Methods like, the pear of anguish. That's a metal device shaped like a pear that's inserted into any one of the sinner's orifices. And it consists of four leaves that expand and separate. And they're manipulated by the torturer, or the holy one, as I like to call him, who turns a nut at the top of the instrument and separates the leaves to their maximum, just tearing and shredding the tendons and the flesh inside whatever orifices it was inserted into.